I guess first of all, you know, how are you doing? And when you come down here and you see this, how does that make you feel?
Heartbroken. Obviously, there was a lot of blood, sweat, and tears over the last 3 years developing a project that we are all very, very proud of. And if you can imagine getting that call late Sunday night, early Monday morning, and reading text messages as your phone's blowing up on the nightstand, and seeing what the words are saying to you in those messages, I thought we were living a nightmare, you know. And then you come down and see everything. I'm doing fine. A couple weeks have passed. You know, our team members at RISE are certainly affected by this as well. I feel for all the specific team members who worked on this every day over the last 3 years. My heart really goes out to those folks. You know, you can rebuild buildings, and that's what we intend to do. And we'll get past this, but right now it's been tough.
Yeah, I mean, and a lot of people don't think about the employees, but that's what you think about.
Yes.
You know, and you know, when you say blood, sweat, and tears, I mean, what kind of work have they been doing to get this, you know, to this point? Turn my phone off here. What's the blood, sweat, and tears part? What kind of work did they do to get this to this point? I mean, you guys were almost done.
Yeah, we were getting ready for resident move-in. We had some families moving in just 6 days after the fire. And so, you know, we were buttoning up the final finishes, final clean in a lot of respects at different parts of the building, making sure everything was tidy and in its order so that the initial families could enjoy, you know, what this building really was all about. So it was intense.
Is there one moment when you realized the magnitude of what had happened? Like, were you driving over the bridge and you saw the flames, or tell me that?
Yeah, you know, when you see the pictures that were sent to me, you know, through the course of the night, and then getting over here early on a Monday morning and seeing it with your own eyes and coming over the hard bridge, you know, I mean, I literally just broke down. You know, you see something that's so close to you and your company, and to see it devastated and the tragedy, you know, that revolves around it, it was tough. And then you see JFRD, JSO, all the city agencies down here paying attention and doing amazing work to help put out the fire, create organization around the environment here downtown on these four streets that these small businesses were affected, as well as us. So you're all of a sudden, you kind of get into organization mode. All right, how do we first of all get this put out, and then secondly, how do we get organized around so that not everybody's affected for a long period of time? And that's kind of where we still are today.
Yeah. You know, as president of the company, RISE, Doro, tell me about the name. I get the feeling that it's more than a business for you.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, our name means something. It means something to us. It's very intentional. RISE, not only the brand, but our company name, and we brand our properties with RISE. RISE stands for eight attributes: reasonable, reliable, inspired, impactful, serve and simplify, experienced and empowering. And again, that means something to me and everyone that works within the company. And when you put your name on something, you hold yourself accountable, not only to yourself and your team members, but everybody in the community. We want that brand to be recognizable for being high quality, doing what we say we're going to do, and providing great service. And so we made a conscious decision to name our properties using those eight attributes in mind, so that everybody knows when they see RISE, they see and know that they're going to have a good experience with us.
Yeah, kind of like what we were talking about earlier. I mean, you hope that people see that. I mean, in the sense that it's just not just a company that you know your heart's in it, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
Tell me about. You guys were relocated to Jacksonville from Valdosta, Georgia?
Valdosta, Georgia.
When did you make that decision, and what were some of the factors behind it?
Yeah, again, thank you for that. So we were located in Valdosta, Georgia since 1995. And in 2021, we elected to move the corporate headquarters down here. We still have an office in Jacksonville, but the impetus behind moving down here was our business was starting to really focus on Northeast Florida and Central Florida. And we figured we needed to be a Florida company in order to do what our mission was here in Florida. And, you know, you look at the demographics of Jacksonville, you look at the migration, you look at the growth trajectory and patterns that we've had and enjoyed over the last few years, and we were already working here before we moved our headquarters. And all of those items put into the stew made for a really strong decision for us. We love being here. You know.
Yeah. So you moved to North Florida. How big is your company?
We're roughly 230 employees between construction company, management company, and development company.
Yeah. I got the sense, and I think I've read this as well, and you might have said something in the press conference about your faith. Your faith in God and how you feel as if you're doing what you are called to do. In a sense, am I right about that?
You are. Thank you for asking that question, Tarek. We are a Christian-based company. We are not shy about our values. It's in our mission statement. You know, as I mentioned in the initial press release, when the fire was still burning behind us that Monday evening, our motto is to love, serve, and care, and that's what we're going to do all the time. Anyone can build buildings. It's more about impacting lives of the residents who call your buildings home. And we take that extremely seriously. Our mission is to impact lives positively every day, one life at a time. And so that is at the forefront of all decisions that we make. Right, wrong, or indifferent, that's who we are. And I appreciate your question.
Yeah. You mentioned to me that it was emotional for you. I mean, mm-hmm. Could you just tell me a little bit more about that and tie it into your faith and what this meant to you as it came down?
Yeah, you know, it's you're overtaken by something that, you know, you fall in love with your projects. They all mean something very, very important to what we're trying to accomplish. I just mentioned we're trying to impact lives. We were going to impact a ton of families living down here in this amazing sports district of downtown Jacksonville. And taking and understanding the good that can be done through creating residences, creating experiences, allowing other families to call your facility home, it does get emotional because we're right at the impetus of having people be able to call this place home. And then the unfortunate fire broke out. And
there's a thing called resiliency, right?
Yes.
I mean, there's always been trials and tribulations. It's not life if it's not some kind of trials and tribulations.
Right.
Like, how do you make sense of it all?
You know, we're the development business is not an easy business. Obviously, a lot of businesses aren't easy businesses. Yeah. And we do endure trials and tribulations every day. But we're perseverant. The whole company has a strong mentality, goal, vision. You know, we still really hope to see Doro do what we wanted it to do when we drew the plans over 3 years ago. You know, and God willing, we're gonna see that through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what do you want the people of Jacksonville to know about rebuilding and what the future holds for your company, for the Doro in downtown?
Well, we're still going through a process, right? This is still relatively new, and we are working through the investigation. We're working through the insurance processes, but with all the goal in mind of again calling Doro home someday. What I would like to take a moment to do, though, is thank some groups. JFRD, JSO, the mayor's office, these local businesses who have also been impacted by the unfortunate event that took place on Sunday a couple of weeks ago. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for your support. You guys have all done yeoman's work in helping us, A, put the fire out and create organization around this. And without them, you know, no one's prepared to deal with this. It takes a village, and I'm really glad that we had the village helping us that we had.
Yeah, you mentioned to me earlier off camera just about the community support. I mean, that's got to make you feel good about, one, tell me about the community support, and then how does it make you feel about making the decision to move from Valdosta to Jackson?
Yeah, thank you. The community has, it's amazing, Tarek, how many text messages, phone calls, emails that me and my partners have received. In fact, all the employees of the company have been reached in some form or fashion by people throughout the community. People who do what we do for a living, offering support, people we don't know, people who do have different careers. They have been reaching out to us, and I can't tell you how much that fills my heart and makes us so, as you said, so happy that we made the decision to be here. You know, Jacksonville is a caring community, and it was evidenced by the support and the outreach that we've had over the last couple of weeks. And I am so thankful for all of those folks and companies that have reached out to us. We appreciate your thoughts and prayers.
And last question, we discussed it earlier, just as far as about, you know, there was an article about possibilities of the redesign being with steel and with concrete. Are you at a position where you can comment on that for the future?
Yeah, you know, it's still early. It's still early. We still have a lot of questions ourselves that need to be answered. And, you know, as I mentioned earlier, we're going through a process. And as that process unfolds and gets to the finish line, I'll be able to share more answers about what our opportunities for rebuild are and what that could look like. But today, as you and I were speaking, I don't know what the future holds as far as what kind of structural system or what have you will ultimately become the new Doral.
Okay.